On Sunday morning in Sahar, an industrial city in northern Oman, unemployed workers tried to stage a small demonstration outside a labour ministry. They were almost immediately arrested by Omani police, who rarely tolerate any dissent against the country's unelected regime. The next day, another group tried again, as people filmed fearfully from a distance. They were outnumbered by police and quickly taken away. There were similar scenes in Salala, a city 850 kilometres away from Sahar. And when a larger group back in Sahar tried to protest in front of the Labour Ministry, they were chased away by riot police. Tear gas was fired and stones were thrown. The British government is a close ally of Oman and has allowed more than £16 million of tear gas to be exported to the country in recent years. Oman's riot police also receive extensive UK training, and nearly 100 British troops serve Oman's Sultan under secret rules of engagement. Amid the tear gas being fired, armoured vehicles were seen approaching Sahar as riot police began snatching people from the streets who they suspected of filming the protests. By Monday afternoon, it looked as if the protesters were defeated. But then a large crowd gathered back on the streets of Salalah. Many of them had come down from the rugged Dafar region, which has a long history of resistance to the Sultan's regime and his allied British forces. They were able to march past the main police station in Salalah without being stopped, as authorities appeared uncertain how to respond. They protested against unemployment and corruption in Oman. And by nightfall, the authorities announced that protesters arrested on Sunday and Monday would be released. But this concession did not stop more protesters from taking to the streets the next day. Unemployed youths in Salalah started a wave of demonstrations that spread from the south to 8 other cities in the north and east of Oman, making them the most extensive protests in Oman since the Arab Spring in 2011. The largest protests were seen in Sahar, where demonstrators gathered under a flyover, which had been at the centre of Arab Spring protests in Oman. Riot police watched as they staged a sit-in, allowing them to pray and even handing out water. But in other parts of Sahar, armoured vehicles and water cannon were seen, as protesters had to move fast through the streets to avoid the police. As night fell on a third day of unprecedented protests in Oman, the authorities announced more jobs would be created for the unemployed, but it looked like the protests could continue until all their demands are met.